Welcome back. For our how-to segment, we're going down to Alfie's to visit a true legend of Queen's University. Now, legend has it that Pat Cook came out of the womb mixing a drink. It was a rum and coke with Bacardi, one lemon. I remember it distinctly.
That's awesome. I mean, if you're like myself around campus, you're probably used to the same drink weekend after weekend. You know, running around your kitchen, taking a bit of milk, a bit of whiskey, a bit of tequila, putting it in one glass and gulping it down. No, not anymore.
We're going to go down to Alfie's and see what Pat Cook's all about in the how-to segment.
Come, my lady, come, my lady, you're my butterfly, sugar, baby. Come, my lady, come, my lady, you're my butterfly, sugar, baby.
Okay, so the first drink we're going to be making today is the classic martini. So the first thing you'd like to do before you start making your drink is choose the spirit that you're going to be using for the base of your alcohol. So you can either use gin or vodka. In this example, we're going to be using gin. And the other ingredient in martinis is dry white vermouth. So before you get started, you need to know what kind of martini you want to make. A dry martini stereotypically has little to no vermouth. A wet martini has more vermouth than usual. And a dirty martini has vermouth as well as a bit of olive juice. So in this example, we're going to be making a dry martini. So you're going to take some ice out of that shaker and throw it in the pint glass. There you go. You're going to put a dash of the vermouth into the pint glass over the ice. This is to coat the ice, not leave too much lasting flavor. A little bit more. There you go. That's good. All right. Now you're just going to put the shaker on top of the pint glass. Hold it tight. There you go. And just give it a little stir. All right. Now you're going to strain out the vermouth. There you go. Wonderful. So now the ice is coated in vermouth, so it won't be too domineering of a flavor. Now you're going to grab your bottle of gin. And you're going to pour out 2 ounces into the glass. Right up to the line. There you go. And one more. All right. Now, it's very important that you never shake a martini. This is actually called bruising the spirit, and it really dilutes the alcohol. It makes it more watery than actually potent. So you're going to take a spoon and just give it a nice stir so that the alcohol is cold, nice and hard. There you go. And then you're going to grab your strainer again. Put it right on top. You're going to push it down with your index finger. All right, and you're going to strain it right into the glass. And there you go. And now with the garnish for a martini, you can use an olive that's been rinsed of its brine, or you can use a lemon twist to add a bit of citrus essence to the drink. So throw in your olive, and there's your classic martini. So the next drink we're going to be making today is called the White Freezy, and you can find it on the menu at the Queen's Pub and Alfie's Nightclub. So you're going to start out by filling this rocks glass here with ice. All right, that's fine. You're going to grab 1 ounce of this banana liqueur. You're going to grab 1 ounce of the sourpuss raspberry. All right. And now you're going to top it all up with some cranberry juice. That's wonderful. All right. And to finish it off, you're going to garnish it with a cherry.
Amazing.
And an orange peel. And that is your White Freezy.
Come, my lady, come, my lady, you're my butterfly, sugar, baby. Come, my lady, come, my lady, you're my butterfly, sugar, baby. Such a sexy, sexy, pretty little thing. This April bitch, you got me sprung with your tongue ring. And I ain't gonna lie, cause your loving gets me high. So to keep you by my side, there's nothing that I won't try.